Corbin hasn't been getting the matches he wants.
Also, some more stat grinding matches. We're pretty much maxed out on everything we want maxed out, and we're a 98 across the board. So there's really no other place to go except to... Yeah, I guess it's it, buddy.
I'm sick of waiting around to get what we both know I deserve. When are you going to give me a shot at your Universal Championship?
I'm not sure you deserve anything other than a good ass kicking.
You know I've been better than you since the day you stepped foot in the Performance Center. So what's the matter? Scared the entire world will find that out?
It all comes full circle.
I already proved I'm better than you when we fought over the Intercontinental Championship. But if you want to get embarrassed again, then I'll take you on at some point.
At some point? I want a title match now.
You think you're the only one coming after my championship? You're going to have to wait your turn.
Paragon J. Pierce didn't become an international sensation by waiting for anything.
PCs with you guys. This was this week. Yeah, problem. No, just messy. Didn't forget. I'll be there. Happy to help out the new guys. What I like to think about is that at this point, you're not a new guy. You've been on NXT for 1 year, then Raw for 1 year, now you're on SmackDown for your third year. Jeez, Rib. Chase, oh my god. I've become all the time world. I'm currently a world champion. I was a world champion twice before this time. Hey, you're Intercontinental Champion. That's incredible. Don't deny that. That is an accomplishment, my dude. Seriously, dude. Especially, what, 397 days? That's insane. boy, I'm glad I gave you guys some actual news to listen to, because it's really boring and you don't have commentary. Shinsuke Nakamura and Paragon J. Pierce.
Shinsuke! What are you doing? What the hell are you thinking? What the heck, guys? Get out of here, Shinsuke! Paragon, get out of the ring right now! Oh!
Come on, stop it! That's enough! God!
Anyone else want to step up to us? Huh? That's what I thought.
How did you get an established talent like Shinsuke Nakamura as your lackey? Anything.
So when you're able to pick yourself up off this mat, I expect to hear a next in line for a Universal Championship match. Or this will only get worse. I don't want to spend another second in this hellhole. Let's go.
Like, seriously, why is Shinsuke your lackey? Why? Waiting for a response. You got what you wanted. You move for the Universal Championship. But first, I want revenge for what you did. I'll take you and Shinsuke Nakamura on by myself. Teaming up with Shawn Michaels? Sorry, Chase, but you just don't compete with that. Paragon has been with the HK since day one, and this only made things worse. So give me a tag with Shawn. Dusting off the boots. Now this is really funny because the latest patch dropped yesterday. And all of the My Rise exclusive characters, like this rendition of Shawn Michaels, were made playable characters. Also made playable is a My Rise version of Shinsuke Nakamura, which is straight up not King Nakamura, thank God. So, you know, yeah. Getting to play as Shawn Michaels, current, pretty cool.
This is gonna be good!
The following contest is a tag team match, scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring. At a combined weight of 497 pounds, the captain, Isaiah Bradley, and the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
When this guy hung up the pads and entered the ring, there was speculation he'd go back to football the second things got too tough.
He squashed those rumors pretty fast and displayed amazing dedication to his training at the Performance Center and fierce determination in his matches.
And their opponents first, from Arlington, Virginia.
You are looking at one of the most vicious strikers this industry. He kicks like lightning. Yeah, Shinsuke Nakamura has a bad attitude to match.
No, he doesn't. He just doesn't like you, Saxton.
And from Kyoto, Japan, weighing in at 220 pounds, he is the artist known as Shinsuke.
Guys, what kind of artist actually is Shinsuke Nakamura?
Nakamura makes art with his brutality.
And Byron, he's the type of artist that thrills the WWE Universe with everything he does. He's like a Picasso in the ring. Saxton wouldn't know art in an art museum.
All right.
What an absolute stunning turn of events that has led up to this match tonight.
Yeah, Paragon Jay appears and Shinsuke Nakamura invading the Performance Center, laying everyone out is one way to get the champion's attention.
It worked, didn't it? And now the winner of this match will get to choose their Universal Championship match stipulation. Advantage, Paragon.
Shoulder vulnerable.
Okay.
Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly. Oh, man, you can see he is feeling it now.
Really just laying it in.
Big elbow.
Come on.
Looks like he has his finger on the trigger now. The wherewithal to counter HBK.
Can Pierce recover from this adversity?
Hits him with the counter. He's open to start a rush of his own with that attack. Oh, what a counter. Tagged into the action.
This is actually legitimately a dream match in someone else's mind. Do a bunch of moves.
Let's go.
locked in. You can almost hear the opponents yelling in agony. Shawn Michaels, no stranger to high risks. From the top, nobody home. Set him up for Russian leg sweep. Michaels taking control. Nakamura struggling with this onslaught. High risk.
Getting rid of the turnbuckle pad.
Don't say that too loud, Saxon. You might get caught.
Finds the answer for Nakamura.
Does the official not see him removing the turnbuckle pad?
Keep your voice down.
Enable the counter.
Nakamura reversing the momentum.
Good chance for him to regain his wits.
Your opponent's arm.
Nakamura might need to find a reprieve.
Good luck stopping Shawn Michaels at this rate.
The top of a diving hammer strike. I can hear
I the charge up the band.
Ladies and gentlemen, HBK. HBK got all of it. He's going to the pin. This could be it. Into the pay window. Two. Oh my lord, how in the world is he still going?
Every kick out taking so much energy to muscle.
Music. Are you kidding me?
Nakamura could be conquered.
Shifts it back onto him.
Is quick and courtesy of Shawn Michaels.
Nakamura having a tough time here.
And more attacks to his core could hinder his offense.
Nakamura was ready for that one.
Impressive reversal from Michaels. Oh my God. Pendulum backbreaker.
Big time.
Going way up high. Adrenaline is pumping, and the WWE Universe is on
X and
his
Y.
Side.
Setting up might just have what it takes to keep Nakamura down.
This one has to be over. And Pierce is on the down. Shoulders down. On the ropes. Referee breaks the count.
He could pin his opponent right here.
It's over. Still only got one.
If that won't beat him, I'm not sure anything will.
Heel hook. Look at this. Oh, that's so painful. Hard to watch. Too.
Well, yeah, a little bit.
Andy gets the better of HBK.
Come on.
He's tagging out. Boom. Did you hear the impact? Bam. Down he goes.
Uh-oh. This isn't going to be pretty.
Super.
Drop kick.
Come on.
Nothing fancy there. Spinning Uranagi. Placed him in the corner. Leaving himself open here.
Now, guys, I can't think of a worse place for him to be right now.
Oh, damn. Shawn Michaels. No. How dare you use Shawn Michaels?
Will this be enough? To keep this guy down. Arm is trapped. Crossface submission. Will they tap? Pearson. There's the save. How close was that? I don't like the look in his eye here, folks.
That's 4-5 sweet chin musics in one match. Oh my god.
Here are your winners.
Yeah, I think that made sense. If you're going to portray Shawn Michaels as someone who needed to get back into shape and kick off his ring rust for an actual match, having him 2v1 guys, a younger tag team essentially, that's how it should go. But he's still Shawn Michaels. A still guy. The band just needs some retuning and fine-tuning until it got the point across. Steel Cage. Last man standing at the PC. Yeah, this would be super poetic. This would be the most poetic way to end the whole thing. I don't normally want to play a last stand match, but all right. All right. Yeah, I've decided this is going to be the last episode, more or less. I'm not super interested in continuing to play this. Or at the very least, I feel like it's time for me to try out the female version for myself. I'll work out how to deal with the heel and face thing as we go along, but...
Tonight, we're coming to you live with a special broadcast from the WWE Performance Center as the Universal Champion will defend his title against Paragon Jay Pierce in a last man standing match.
We're back where it all started for both these superstars.
They used to be wide-eyed recruits, and now they're battle-tested warriors looking to take one step back in order to take a giant leap forward. What a kick.
Ducking out of trouble. Knee to the gut.
The challenger's looking shaken. Taking a few licks here, but nothing that'll keep you down for the count of 10.
Nothing like the old gallows pole.
Getting up, but doesn't have a clue what's coming at him. Perhaps thinking about what to do next here. Check their face after that one.
One.
Got the leg.
Look at this. He just tossed the leg.
Oh, my goodness.
From the ground up.
Power slam.
Come on.
And Pierce is down a demoralizing spot.
Can Pierce recover from this adversity?
He's got him in the crosshairs. Clothesline knocked down. Here we go. Comeback time.
This superstar's on fire.
You know, in all honesty, I like going back here because of the bookend nature of the whole thing. Because if I really stop and think about it, then Paragon doesn't deserve to be crowned Universal Champion.
One.
totally vibing with the WWE Universe right now.
Four.
Does the official not see him removing the turnbuckle pad?
Keep your voice down.
Six.
He is getting rid of the turnbuckle pad.
Don't say that too loud, Sax. You might get caught.
Back by the counter.
That might be what gets him out of jeopardy.
Not allowing that to go on any longer.
Perilous position to be in right now.
Yeah. Oh, snake eyes caving in their face.
And Pierce is down a demoralizing spot.
Can Pierce recover from this adversity?
They're gonna pile on more offense rather than let the count go on.
Desperate attempt here to get back on his feet.
Flipping the script on him there.
Oh, man, you can see he is feeling it now.
Just carrying the opposition anywhere they want.
Running power slam! Treating the torso to yet another attack.
Tough position to be caught in here.
Ooh, dropped right on their face.
Just defenseless as the momentum is against him. He's got to boost up his levels of aggression at this point.
Oh, a sudden cutter.
Looks like the champ is going to retain.
One. Two.
Yeah.
Three.
Seven now.
Eight. Nine. Ten. Okay, retain.
That's it. Oh, no, that's fine.
Here is your winner, and still the WWE Universal Champion, the Captain, Isaiah Bradley.
What an emphatic victory, guys. No contest.
That's why they call it light work, Cole. Barely even broke a sweat.
That's just beautiful. What a perfect ending to that rivalry. This is probably the best way to end that entire storyline with him. It really is. Also, what way to put the Performance Center over? And that is that. Taught my new class an invaluable lesson out there, champ. How to put a bully in their place. Appreciate you. I appreciate that, Sean. I really do. But yeah, that's basically it. Yeah. Like I said, all this really just feels like not really story important, so. That's it for the men's story, at least for the face side. If I ever come back and do a heel version of it, it'll probably have to be released as one large video instead of its own thing, its own proper Let's Play, but that's going to be it for My Rise. 22K. I guess if I do come back to this game after the female My Rise mode, it'll probably be Universe mode. But you know what? It was fun to play it while it lasted, no matter what. So yeah, I'll definitely see what the female storylines have in store for me. Thank you guys for watching. This is Very Melon Man telling you all to have a great day. Great day, all of you.